Hello, welcome to my channel. Welcome. Today I am going to discuss about case study of clamp coupling or compression coupling, or we can say that split Muff coupling. In previous lectures I already discussed about design procedure of a clamp coupling or compression coupling. So in this lecture I am going to discuss about a case study of clamp coupling. So for case study, we have a statement or we have a given data. It is required to design a split Muff coupling to transmit 50 kilowatt power at 120 rpm. The shaft, key and clamp bolt are made up of plain carbon steel, as I already mentioned you in the design procedure, which has 30C8 and SYT of 400 Newton per m square. The yield strength in a compression is 150% of the tensile yield strength. The factor of safety for the shaft and key bolt is 5. The number of clamping bolt is 8. The coefficient of friction between sleeve and shaft is 0.3. So design a clamp coupling. So in this statement, given data are power 50 kilowatt or 15 to 10 to the power 3 watt. The speed at which the power is supplied is 120 rpm. SYT for key, shaft and bolt material is 400 Newton per m square. And one more relation is given to us is yield compressive strength is 150%. It means 1.5 times of SYT. So we can say that 400 multiplied by 1.5 times of SYT is SYC. Factor of safety for key, shaft and bolt material is 5, and number of bolt, which is known as small n, is 8. With respect to coefficient of friction is 0.3. In step 1, first we need to calculate a permissible stress to check whether our component, which has some dimension, is safe enough to bear the load. So we need to compare with respect to permissible stress, which is on the basis of induced stress. So permissible stress can be calculated for shaft, key, bolt material. As we know that shaft, key and bolt are having the same material, so sigma t, sigma c and tau can be calculated on the basis of SYT, SYC and shear strength, shear yield strength, on the basis of Rankine theory and Guest and Tresca theory, or we can say that maximum principal stress theory and maximum shear stress theory. Tau relation is for maximum shear stress theory, sigma relation is for maximum principal stress theory. Sigma t is equal to SYT by FOS. SYT is known or given to us, 400 divided by 5, so sigma t will be 80 Newton per m square. Sigma c is equal to SYC by FOS. SYC relation is given to us with respect to SYT, 1.5 times of SYT divided by FOS. So sigma c is equal to 1.5 times of 400 divided by 5. Sigma c is equal to 120 Newton per m square. Further, tau with respect to maximum shear stress theory or guest Tresca theory, tau is equal to SY divided by FOS, which is known as SYT divided by 2 FOS, or 0.5 times of SYT divided by FOS. Putting the value of SYT, so we can calculate tau is equal to 40 Newton per m square. After calculating permissible stress, we need to calculate the dimension of the different component which is used to design a split Muff coupling. So in a split Muff coupling, first we can design a shaft which has a circular section, small d diameter. It is easy to design a shaft because it has a only diameter small d, which can be calculated on the basis of torsional equation T by J tau by R. After simplifying T by J tau by R, J will be polar moment of pressure, T will be torque transmitted, tau is a shear stress, permissible shear stress, and R will be die of the shaft divided by 2. So D cube is equal to 16 d pi tau will be our equation. So to calculate the die of the shaft, we need to have a torque value. Here tau is known to us, tau t is not known to us. So to calculate T, we can use the power and speed relation, which is equal to power into 60 divided by 2 pi n. From this equation, we can calculate torque in Newton meter. Power is given to us 15 into 10 to the power 3 watt into 60 divided by 2 pi, and n is given to us is 120 rpm. Putting this value in this torque equation, torque will be 3978.8 Newton meter. Putting this torque into this diameter equation, torsion equation, we can calculate dia is equal to approximately 79.71 mm. To calculate dia, first we need to simplify this torque value into Newton mm, because here tau is in Newton per m square, so torque should also be in Newton mm. So 10 to the power 3 can be multiplied in torque, so d will be equal to 79.71 mm from this equation, and which can be simplified as a 80 mm or rounded off as a 80 mm. After calculating dia of the shaft, we can calculate the dimension of the sleeve. In the dimension of sleeve, capital D is the outer dia of the sleeve, a small d will be the inner dia of the sleeve in which shaft will be fitted, which is small d is already calculated with respect to dia of the shaft. So the dia of the outer dia of the sleeve or muff is equal to 2.5 times of dia of the shaft. Dia is already calculated 80 into 2.5, capital D will be 200 mm. Length of sleeve relation with respect to dia of the shaft is 3.5 times of dia of the shaft. So from this equation we can calculate length of the sleeve, which is equal to approximately 280 mm. After calculating sleeve, we need to calculate the dimension of the clamping bolt. This clamping bolt equation is already derived in a design procedure of split muff coupling. You can watch that video and understand what are the basic concept behind this equation. So here I am considering P1 is a tensile force on each bolt. Number of bolt here is given to us is 8. Small d1 is the core dia of the clamping bolt, which is resisting dia to bear the load of P1. P1 is equal to stress into area. As we know that stress is equal to load upon area, so load can be calculated with respect to stress into area. D1 is not known to us, sigma t is known to us. If we calculate P1, then we can simply calculate the dia of core dia of the clamping bolt. To calculate P1, we have a simplified relation 2t by pi d small n. N is the number of bolt, small d is the dia of the shaft, mu is the coefficient of friction, and t is the torque transmitted. Putting this value, we can calculate P is equal to 41,437.5 Newton. Putting this value in this above equation, stress equal to load into area, load is equal to stress into area, we can calculate core dia of the clamping bolt, which is approximately 25.68069 mm, which can be rounded off as 26 mm. So further, with the help of small d1 can also be calculated on the basis of empirical relation. Empirical relation is 1.5 times of dia of shaft plus 15. Putting the value of d, which is already calculated, is equal to 80 mm in step 2 dia of the shaft, d1 can be calculated as approximately 27 mm. Whether the stress is equal to load into area relation or empirical relation is used to calculate core dia of the clamping bolt. After calculating the clamping bolt dia, we can calculate the dimension of the key, which is used to lock the shaft into the sleeve to transmit torque without sleep. So key design is the most important part, which is here I am using flat or rectangular key to lock shaft or key to transmit power or torque. So in flat key, we know that width of the key B is more than the height of the key. Here B is the height of the width of the key, H is the height of the key, L is the length of key, and D is the dia of the shaft. So with respect to this relation, we can calculate the width, height, and length of the key. width is 1/4 times of the dia of the shaft, height is the 1/6 times of the dia of the shaft, and L is the length of the sleeve divided by 2. Because one half of the shaft is inserted from the one end of the sleeve, and remaining half of the shaft, output shaft, is inserted from the another end of the sleeve. Both shafts are locked with respect to half of the length of the sleeve into the shaft key way. So we can calculate length is equal to length of the sleeve divided by 2. As we know that dia of the shaft is 80 mm. So width is equal to 80 by 4, width of the key is 20 mm, height is equal to 1/6 times of the dia of the shaft, dia is 80, 80 divided by 6, 13.33, which can be rounded off as a 15 mm, height is 15 mm, width is 20 mm, and length of the sleeve is 280, so length of the key will be 280 divided by 2, 140 mm. Now we need to check whether this width and height is safe enough to bear the load or not. So check process is done on the basis of shear and crushing stress, which we already done in the Muff coupling design or a sleeve design, sleeve coupling design, which is a basic type of coupling. So tau relation and sigma c is relation is already derived in a design of key lecture. You can watch that video. I am here using that relation. Tau is equal to 2t by bdl, b is the width of the key, t is the dia of the shaft, l is the length of the key, and t is the torque transmitted. Tau is the shear stress, which we need to calculate to compare with the permissible stress. Sigma c is the compressive shear stress, which is used to compare with respect to compressive permissible stress. T is the torque transmitted, D is the dia of the shaft, H is the height of the key, L is the length of the key. Putting all those known values into this, both the terms, both the equation right hand side, we can calculate tau is equal to 35.51 and sigma c will be 94.71 Newton per mm square. Comparing this both the values with the permissible stresses, tau and sigma c are lesser than the permissible value. What are the value of permissible stress for tau and sigma c? Tau will be 40 Newton per m square and sigma c will be 120 Newton per m square. Sigma c is less than 120 megapascal or Newton per m square, or tau is less than 40 Newton per m square. So we can say that our design is safe enough to bear that load. So this is the basic design procedure or case study of the split Muff coupling. I hope you understand the basic concept related to this. If you have any doubt, then please go back to design procedure of the first, go back to the design procedure of split coupling, split Muff coupling. Then after, please design, please go through this basic procedure to design a case study of clamping or compression or a split Muff coupling or a split sleeve coupling. So I hope you like this video. If you have any doubt related to this video, then please comment below this video, and if you have any suggestion, then please comment me in this channel. Any video you can choose in this channel, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.